This is the hot new Spark from DJI. It's almost like a mini Mavic Pro. Super portable, tons of smart features packed in, and it's the most affordable DJI drone ever built. I'm Ben from AuthenTech. Let's jump right in for an in-depth review. The Spark comes with a very convenient carrying case that's molded to fit the Spark perfectly, propellers and all. The first thing you'll notice is the tiny size of the Spark drone. It's impressive DJI was able to pack so much technology into something so small that fits in the palm of your hand. The Spark is lightweight, only 300 grams with battery and props installed. Even at this cheaper price point, they didn't skimp on build quality or materials. It looks and feels ultra premium. After removing the Spark from the box, you'll see the props have color indicators, making them quick and easy to install. Simply press them on the drone arm and turn, and they'll auto lock into place. The props are also foldable, easy for storage and transportation. No worries about them bending or breaking. Prop guards are optional. These are easy to attach as well. Simply rotate around the motor arm and close the clasp to lock into place. Not only do these protect the Spark's propellers, but people and objects around the flying space as well. The box also includes the 1480 milliamp hours battery, and there's a charging hub. Here you can charge up to 3 batteries simultaneously. Very cool design. The Spark battery is ergonomic. Pull the side tabs to unlock from the drone and slide it into the charging slot. Like typical DJI drones, the battery also has LEDs to indicate battery life and status. Flight times on a single charge are advertised up to 16 minutes, which is very impressive. More on this shortly. A key feature of the Spark is the camera. It features a 2-axis mechanical gimbal, which is an incredible feat for its tiny size. The camera lens is 25mm fixed focal length at f2.6. Up front are the object avoidance sensors. These are so convenient to have, flying with confidence knowing it'll prevent all possible crashes while moving forward. In the rear, hidden behind a Spark cover, is a micro USB port and the micro SD card slot. Another observation I made was the inclusion of 4 rubber pads on the bottom of the Spark. This not only keeps the Spark from sliding on a flat surface, but it slightly raises the drone off the ground, giving it clearance for the camera gimbal and other sensors. I always appreciate this attention to detail. It's difficult to explain how small the Spark really is. It's almost as if you have to see it in person to believe it. The main body is smaller than my Galaxy S8, and it totally reminds me of a mini Mavic Pro. Now let's charge up the battery and go out for some test flights. Starting with some battery tests. In real world examples, I'd fly around for around 10 to 12 minutes when it prompted me to come back and land. To go the extra mile, I set up a time lapse to really test this out. Battery is fully charged, and I simply let it hover for the whole time. 86 degrees outside, wind was pushing at about 11 miles per hour, and I had the prop guards attached, which add extra weight. Right at 10 minutes, the app prompted me to return home and land. About 30 seconds later, kept warning me to land, critically low power. And then right at 11 and a half minutes, it auto-landed itself. Now on a quick side note, Google the term translational lift, and one could make a solid argument that hovering consumes more battery power than forward flight. Thus, that 16-minute goal could be attainable, especially without those prop guards. Either way, between 11 to 16 minutes of flight time per battery is still good. To fully charge takes only 45 minutes in my testing, and if I were you, I would definitely pick up a few spare batteries. Simultaneously charge them on the hub, and you'll be good to go for a while. Connected with that hover test, the stability of flight and winds are impressive. I went out flying on a day with gusts up to 15 and 20 miles per hour, and you can see the strong winds in the trees, and the Spark's precision hovering worked well, especially for its small size. Flying the Spark is a cinch, perfect for beginners and those who've never used a drone before. It takes less than 30 seconds to turn on and start flying. One of the unique and neat features of the Spark is that you can fly the drone with just your phone or tablet. Sometimes this just makes sense, not need to charge and grab a dedicated Spark controller, but instead use my phone, which is always on me, for a quick and easy flying experience. All I need to do is turn on the Spark, connect via Wi-Fi on the mobile device, launch the DJI Go app, and I'm all ready to fly. The Spark has front-facing object avoidance, meaning it'll help prevent itself from flying forward into any object. In my testing, this feature worked great and wouldn't allow me to fly forward or too close to anything. This is another huge feature for beginners and offers safety and confidence while flying. And another confidence booster, return to home. With one button swipe, or if the drone disconnects, it'll auto come home and land itself. This gives you a great peace of mind. The max transmission range while flying the Spark with your phone over Wi-Fi is 262 foot distance and 164 foot height. If you choose to buy the dedicated controller sold separately, that range is super extended, up to 6,500 feet, over a mile away. Another thing to note, speed is limited to 6.5 miles per hour when flying with a mobile device. However, that's greatly increased to 31 miles per hour in sport mode with the dedicated controller. I seriously can't wait for that to come out and start racing this little Spark FPV all around. That's going to be a ton of fun. Now onto the key feature of the Spark, the camera. The 12 megapixel sensor captures beautiful aerial photographs. And the 1080p 30fps video looks fantastic. Video bitrate is recorded at 24 megabits per second. Image quality looks great and the gimbal is very stable, giving you smooth aerial shots. I'm very impressed with the results. Not only do I have exposure control over the camera, but it has cool built-in camera modes like auto exposure bracketing for HDR photos or shallow focus. So once I've taken my picture, I can open it via the playback and play with the depth of field and focus to create that nice blurry background. There's panorama mode, select vertical or horizontal, and the Spark will auto pan and tilt the camera mid-air to capture photos with enough overlap to stitch together for a dynamic wide angle shot. Overall, the photos and videos look dang good on such a small camera. And if you want to see my Spark vs. Mavic video, I'll link that down below. Now DJI has also included smart shooting modes like Active Track, which has always been one of my favorites. Active Track will auto follow my subject and keep them in camera frame, even if that object is moving. You can even tell it to auto circle the object as well, while tracking and moving simultaneously. This makes for some super cool cinematic shots. There are new smart shooting modes as well. Quick shots are automated camera and drone moves that record a 10-second video clip you can share on social medias. I personally like the Droney, which automatically pulls up and away while keeping subject in center frame. It also has Helix Move, where the Spark flies upward and spiraling around the target, and then Rocket to pull straight up and above your subject. Another big feature DJI is promoting is called Gesture Control. This is where you can feel like a Jedi Knight and control your Spark with just your hands. You can palm launch by facing the camera, press the power button twice, wait for the LEDs to turn green and the props will spin up and the drone will slowly take off and out of your hand. I could see this being really useful if you're on a boat or some precarious area and there's no solid ground. Another useful feature is palm land. Same idea, face the camera, put out your hand, and the aircraft will land in your palm. A few other gesture controls. Place your palm out, slowly moving your hand or rotating around moves the aircraft with you. Wave for a couple of seconds and the Spark will auto fly up and away, and it'll auto start following you. Frame up your hands like a film director and the Spark will flash the front LEDs and snap a selfie photo. There's beckon mode, hold out your arms in a V shape and the Spark will auto come back to you. These are some pretty neat features. Overall, my wish list is very short. I wish that camera could record 4K video, but I have to remind myself most people don't even have 4K screens yet, but the camera is still really good at 12 megapixel. Also, I wish the arms would fold in like the Mavic Pro. It could easily fit in my pocket, but I have a feeling we'll see this in a future model, hopefully. And lastly, I can't wait for that dedicated controller to come out soon. In closing, the Spark is small, safe, and reliable. It's not only easy to use, but fun to fly and packed with crazy impressive technology inside and out. All this at a very affordable price point. I'll give you the link to check out the current price down below. It's the perfect drone for all of you who are on the fence about spending money on a professional DJI drone experience. This new drone should spark your creativity and offer you a world of aerial photo and video possibilities. Now make sure you're following me on Instagram for all my future updates. Huge thanks to DJI for providing me with the sample unit. Consider subscribing if you haven't already. And until next time, let's live authentic.